Hello everyone, welcome to ATZTV, and today I'm with another video, and in today's video we are going to talk about the Premier League 2019-20 season about to kick off, and I'm going to make a prediction of all the teams in the Premier League at which spot they'll be on to this season's table. So without any further ado, let's kick off. Number 20, Brighton. Okay Brighton, let's see. Your sector manager, y'all ended up with just 1 or 2 points from the last season. Y'all were a complete humiliation. I don't think y'all are surviving this season also. With the lower teams getting relegated off, I don't see y'all having standing a chance in front of any other teams. Forget getting out of relegation. If you can get a 19th spot, that would be quite good actually. So, sorry Brighton, goodbye. Number 19, Sheffield United. Okay Sheffield, y'all came second in the championship, y'all got promoted, well done. But when I checked your squad analysis, I don't feel that confident that y'all are going to survive in the Premier League compared to the Champions League. Number 19 for y'all, so sorry, y'all are going back to the championship. Number 18, Newcastle United. Okay Newcastle fans, I have a question for y'all. Why did y'all let Rafa Benitez get sacked? Why are you so against him? He was one of the only saviors of your club. And seeing that the Dubai the Arabs are not taking over your club, I feel it's more like y'all are going to get relegated this season. Horribly badly. So, good luck in trying to stay in the Premier League. But number 18 for y'all. At number 17, Southampton FC. Okay. The only thing I remember Southampton is any player that plays good in Southampton ends up in Liverpool. Okay, that's one very sad thing, but Southampton, nah, y'all were once upon a time one of the most dominating clubs in the Premier League. I can't believe y'all have gone to such a bad condition. Number 17 for y'all. At number 16, we have Aston Villa. Okay, Aston Villa, y'all got promoted, well done. Number 16 for y'all, sure. Y'all have spent a lot of cash, seriously, in this transfer market. I think a number 16 is a very good position for y'all. Y'all will have some difficulty. I feel they'll have a difficulty in playing. But overall, I guess a sweet mid-table will be good for them. And number 15, Burnley. Okay, Burnley. The season before this one, y'all ended up 7th. The European tour affected y'all horribly badly, and the last Premier League was a disaster for y'all. I hope y'all can fight back. A mid-table position for now looks very suitable and stable for y'all, although I would love to bet high. At number 14, Crystal Palace. Okay, let's get it clear. Crystal Palace, y'all, Zaha is going, another player of yours, I can't remember his name, but he's gone to Man United. Yeah, I'm feeling that y'all are giving away your best players, and if y'all do not replace them with better players, y'all are going to be in serious deep trouble. Number 14 is actually a kind of risky spot. I believe that y'all will get someone to replace, but if y'all don't, the number 14 is even not going to come with to y'all so easily. At number 13, we have Bournemouth. Okay, Bournemouth actually had a pretty good start last season. I don't know what happened then later. Disaster did happen to them. They ended up in the mid-tables. But very well played actually. I still see them as a good team to play in the middle of table. So, all the best for y'all, Bournemouth. Nothing much left. Number 12, Norwich City. Okay, Norwich City, y'all are a very good team. I like the way y'all played. Y'all literally from 13 to y'all came first in a championship. That was amazing. Your manager's amazing. I believe y'all can be the next Wolves, but not as successful as a Wolves. A 12th spot will be very good for y'all. Overall, I see y'all having a high potential of competing in the Premier League to be a top side in the future years of the Premier League. At number 11, Watford. Okay, except for last season getting humiliated 6-0, I guess so, by City in the finals. Watford has not had any much impact on the Premier League except for a few matches. But overall, it's good because y'all perform very well and it's nice to see y'all in number 11 position. At number 10, we have West Ham United. Y'all are a good team, y'all have everything, but you don't have what it takes to come in the top 9 in the 98765. The 10th spot is good for y'all because the competition above is also very tough. I can see y'all performing better, but y'all will have to work in miracles to come in the higher tier. And number 9, Wolves. Okay, y'all had a very beautiful season. Wolves had the most beautiful season for a promoted club, I believe, in the Premier League. But I guess the way the European Tour affected Burnley, the same way it's going to affect Wolves, and I'm afraid they may fall down. But I know they can not fall too so down as Burnley. They will surely end up as 9, and they will actually perform well. I have my faith in them. Number 9 for them. Number 8, Everton. Okay. Everton, let's see. Nothing much I can say about y'all, but y'all have the consistency of winning matches, so it is good for a top 10 spot sure for y'all. Y'all have a good consistency, which is very important. Y'all can win, y'all can draw, y'all can even, you see the big teams, y'all can have surprise, we can defeat them in a surprise thing. Surprise results are very good. So I believe that Everton have a good chance in pushing down the opponent teams. So number 8 for them. At number 7, Leicester City. Okay, the Premier League champions, actually no one believed they could be Premier League champions, but next season they became Premier League champions. Leicester City, number 7 for y'all. Y'all have Jimmy Vardy, y'all have some good players, but how long are y'all going to build? You need a replacement, which I feel is very important seeing y'all. Otherwise y'all have a very good club. Number 7, a European spot for y'all. At number 6, we have Chelsea. Okay, now let's talk about the big 6. Chelsea, you lost your best player. You lost your manager who won the European League. I don't know what I can expect from y'all. It's like quite a dead situation. I don't think number 6, Smita Savi may have worked wonders for y'all. But I don't think Frank Lampard will be able to. I think a number 6 spot is quite good for y'all. So that's nice. Number 5, Man United. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer is not going to do anything better for Man United. And seeing the conditions, I don't believe Man United are going to have a good season. I think another European League, they'll be in the European League. The Champions League is not coming to them. They will have, I don't know what. I don't know. It's the transfer market of theirs is also. They are getting good players, but how well are they going to perform? No ideas. So let's see whatever happens. And number 4, Arsenal. Okay. Unai Emery. Y'all want Zaha. Y'all mostly will get him. But speaking otherwise, y'all had a very good, decent season. Y'all may have ended up in the European League. That's not a big thing. Y'all reached the European League finals. That is also a very good thing. So y'all actually performed very well. So that's a very nice thing actually. For y'all, it's good. So it's the second season for Unai Emery. So let's hope he does well. And I believe by seeing Chelsea and United out of the two competition, I think Arsenal stand a chance in the top 4. Number 3, Tottenham. Harry Kane, Dele Alli, and I don't think Eriksen is there, right? So whatever. Y'all have a good team, a good attacking squad, good defending squad, midfield is good. Y'all can score goals, y'all can do everything, and y'all play beautiful. So I believe a number 3 position, another Champions League. Y'all just ended up short in the last Champions League finals. I'm sure top 3 spot for y'all. Number 2, Liverpool. Okay, I know I'm a Manchester City fan, but seriously speaking, Liverpool are a very good club. From the other seasons I have seen, their last season they were terrific. Just lost one match, was and that was the deciding match also. So otherwise Liverpool, actually the only problem is they have everything is good. They have the best defense, they have the best attackers, they have the best goalkeeper. The only problem they suffer is in the entire team, I mean the entire club, is that they bottle too much. They had a 10 points lead versus City in the January, February, and they just lost it. You cannot expect that. Manchester City end up winning 14 matches in a row. They never lost a point in 14 matches. But Liverpool, y'all are supposed to at least defend. it the title. Well, I've bottled it up also in I think the 2013-14 season. This cannot be expected. I think they are going to end up the same condition this time also. It's going to be horrible. But number one, it's obvious, Manchester City. Let's see what do Manchester City have to take to win. Okay, last time they won all the four domestic trophies. That is very exceptional. No one has ever done that. So that's good. We still have Sergio Aguero, who even being above 30, has been scoring 30 goals per season. That is consistency. He's like the Lionel Messi of the Premier League. Very good. He has scored 3 hat-tricks also last season. He's good. Gabriel Jesus, only the left back actually, Mendy was injured. But we had Zinchenko to take, and this time we got Agnel Angelino. Rodri is taking the place of Fernandinho, and a lot of replacements in the team. The defense is super. Only the thing is, we do not be having Vincent Kompany, the only sad part of it. Otherwise, this club is perfectly good. Just beautiful, their performance. The attacking is strong. We have replacement. The bench strength is also too good. And that is why Manchester City are hopefully going to deserve to be the Premier League champions for 3 times in a row. So, thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned for more ATZTV videos coming soon. Please write down in the comment section what you feel about the predictions. And if you want, you can predict the Premier League also in the comment section below. Let's see, I'll mostly do a reaction video after the Premier League season is over on my prediction. So let's see how everything turns out. So hope you all enjoyed the video. Please like, share, subscribe. Let's get my channel to 1,000 subscribers. And yeah, see you all soon. Goodbye.